Okay, why do I have a towel on my lap?
Ew.
Because we're here with Jack Hanna, director emeritus of the Columbus Zoo in Ohio, of course. Got a new kid's book, Jack Hanna's Wild But True. He's brought along a friend who's nibbling my ear right now, a little bent wrong.
We're also here with Jack Hanna's biggest fan, Jesse.
Yes, I got to say,
you insisted. You just came.
One of my favorite parts of GMA is when Jack Hanna comes here and he gets to bring all of his animals.
I know, I agree. More Jack all the time.
But what Charlie Gibson always did, he's the only one to put this, so George is pretty smart right now.
I learned a lot from Charlie.
Yeah, we all learned a lot from Charlie Gibson. And what is this?
A bent bearcat. He won't hurt you, really.
He smells like buttercup.
He won't hurt you really.
This thing, George, really does. When he's full grown, about 100 and something pounds, they can actually take down a king cobra where one drop of venom can kill it.
Well, that doesn't make me feel any better.
You're right. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. You're right. I was just, when they're full grown, George.
he's just still a baby. He only has a little venom.
But no, he does have venom.
It's
going to hurt your shoulders.
Does he like to be held?
Yeah, no.
He is kind of gentle, though.
Yeah, he's very gentle.
The bear lion, by the way, folks, is a bear cat. They have the hair of a bear, kind of sit up and stuff like that. And they also, the hat's important, but who cares? The binturong is an animal also to take down anything. They're in the mongoose family, everyone. They live in Malaysia.
Here's a little fun fact for everybody. I was outside in the loading dock, and the binturong was in the cage with these beautiful clouded leopards.
So you need this.
And Susie was telling me that they have all grown up together. Even though they're totally different species, they're a family.
Right. The cloud leopard, everyone, is one of the rarest cats in the world.
I'm being ambushed.
Ambushed
right now.
Yeah. They're in the Species Survival Plan with the American Zoo Association. You're wearing the wrong clothes. That's the problem.
I'm sorry.
Now I'm awake.
Okay, we're good.
Anyway, the clouded leopard, folks, lives in Malaysia. They're mainly nocturnal. 90% of their life, 90% of their life is in trees. Everyone, they're incredible creatures. They have very long fangs for their size. In the animal's coat, I'm sorry to say, way back in the early 1900s, that's not the problem today. Now it's loss of habitat mainly. But this is an animal that the American Zoo and Aquarium Association, work really hard with the animal, the gene pools we have.
Are you bringing these back? Are you?
Yeah, we are. They're coming back.
Up?
Yeah, they're coming back.
My gosh. Okay. I need to hold one of those.
No, you can't hold that. those are little warthogs, everyone. A warthog, everyone thinks a warthog is just this little old pig that runs around. One interesting thing, which I should have known this, when they have, let's say, six warthogs, they have six teeth. Right, when that one warthog might die or leave, that they'll not suck on the one that, you understand what I'm saying? They won't switch when they nurse.
They won't switch.
No, and the animal also has warts on their face, and that helps to protect them when they fight. They have this animal. They dig these holes, and a lot of times they're going backwards to defend themselves from a lion.
And why can't we hold them?
Any kind of pig. I raised pigs on my farm. You pick up a pig, and everybody's going, "Ee!" We're not hurting the pigs. Pigs just when they picked up, they just have fun and squeal. They're not hurting him at all.
So why don't you give George one? Let's try.
No.
Use this.
Hey, how about it? We're out of time. Thanks.
We'll be right back.